Welcome to this training video on the Quizcom Scan app. In this video, I will show you how you can use this app to scan documents and store them directly in your SharePoint libraries. This video will be broken into three sections. First, we will cover the basics of scanning with the Quizcom Scan app. Then we will look at the configuration options. Finally, we will look at the advanced options, including batch scanning and OCR. I have already installed the Quizcom Scan app. To use it, I must navigate to my document library. The Scan Documents option is accessible under the File menu on the ribbon in my document library. I can click on this option to launch my scanning menu, and I'm presented with three options. I can do a quick scan to just scan a document on my default scanner with no additional options. I can scan using default settings but still see a preview of the scan with options to manipulate it. Or I can choose to edit the settings of how the scan will work and see the preview. I'm going to go through each of these options, but I'm going to start with the quick scan. You will see that has very quickly produced me a scanned document as a PDF, and I can click on that to see what has been scanned. Next, let's look at using scan using default settings. This will give me no configuration options, but it will present me a preview of what has been scanned. This will open the Quizcom Scan client, which you might have to install the first time you use the app. It has various options, including being able to zoom in and out of the scan. You will see that my scanned document is not displayed correctly and needs rotating. You can resolve this by clicking on the scan and then choosing Rotate on the menu. This will present you with several different options in terms of how you can rotate or flip your scanned document. You can perform further manipulations by selecting the scan and choosing Image from the menu. This will provide you options, including being able to adjust the brightness and crop the image. If you want to scan further pages, you can do so by clicking on the Scan option on the menu. If you don't require any of the scan pages, select them and choose the Delete option on the menu. If you have some images you'd like to import into your scan, you can do so by using the Import option on the menu. This will add these image files to your scanned document. When you're happy with the pages which will make up your scan, choose Save from the menu, and this will process to create a PDF in your SharePoint library. If you want more control over how the scan will be produced, choose Edit Settings when launching a new scan. This will present an additional menu. This menu will allow you to define what file type will be produced as a result of your scan. Also set whether one or multiple files will be produced for multi-page scans. You can also set the file name of the output file. This includes using several variables. You also have some options around overwriting existing files and showing a preview for your scan. When you are ready, click on the Scan button and you'll move into the preview if you've selected that option. You can manipulate your scan as shown previously, and when you are ready, click Save to create your scanned file. You will notice that this option takes you to the edit screen for your uploaded document, where you can set additional metadata properties. This is the only one of the three scan options which will present you with the option to set your metadata. Covers the basic options for scanning using the Quizcom Scan app. Now let's look at some of the configuration options. To access these configuration settings, go to the Site Contents menu and then select the Quizcom Scan app. This will present you with the configuration options for the app within your current site, with the option to inherit these settings from the site collection. In these settings, we can set the default file name for the file which is outputted. We can also set the default file type which will be outputted from your scan. Also restrict what options are available to the user when they scan a document. Apply saves the settings and remains in the settings page. Save saves the settings and redirects back to the site. Those were the settings for the site. If you want to configure the scan app settings for a document library, go to that library and on the ribbon under the library tab, choose scan settings. This will present a similar settings screen, but for that specific document library. Once again, you can set the default file name, output format, and user-specific settings. You can also choose to inherit the settings from your site. Okay, now let's look at how you can configure an individual scanner. Launch a scanning of a document and choose to scan using default settings. You'll see the Quizcom Scan client with a preview of your scan. This client replaces any normal scanning client you would use. You can manage your scanners through profiles in this client. Either you can create a new scanner or edit an existing scanner. If you have multiple scanners, you can choose which scanner to scan from by clicking on the little arrow next to the scan option, and this will present you with the option of the different scanners available to you. Okay, let's look at some more advanced scanning options. Launch a new scan and choose to edit settings. Now look at how we can handle scanning multiple pages. In the Edit Scan menu, you can define one file with multiple pages or a file for each page scanned. Let's first look at just one file for multiple pages. See, we have multiple pages scanned here, and when we hit save, the Quizcom Scan app will produce one multi-page file from our scan. Now let's look at producing one file for each page scanned. Launch a new scan and choose Edit Settings. And in this case, choose the option for one file per page. Note, as you'll be generating multiple documents, you'll have the option to set the file names and any metadata. This time, the Quizcom Scan app will produce a file for each of the pages scanned. As it is producing multiple files, you won't be prompted for metadata because you've already defined that on the previous screen. In scan settings, there is the option to compress larger scans as zip files. Launch a new scan to see how this change of setting affects the outputted files. In this case, because our scan was over our defined limit, a zip file has been produced rather than a PDF. This setting can be configured on a site or library basis. The Quizcom scan app also allows us to OCR our scanned documents. To do this, initiate a new scan or you choose a scan setting which will show you the preview window. When the Quizcom scan client opens, choose the OCR option on the menu. This will launch a new screen where you can choose to make PDFs searchable using OCR. You have the option to define which language the OCR will be in. There is also the option to install more languages by downloading them from the list provided. Click OK to exit the OCR setup, and then click Save to create the new scan file, which will be OCR'd. Open your scanned document, and you can now run a search against the text which has been scanned as part of your file. Thank you for watching this training video. If you require any further support from Quizcom, please contact them on the details shown on screen.